Okay, Greg, we're talking Submariners! Submariners, every asshole has one. And, yes. Greg, every asshole seems to have a Submariner. But I got to tell you, this is a very special little ensemble here. We've got your beautiful bluesy. That's a steel and gold.
Yes.
Which I absolutely love.
Mm-hmm.
We've got my No Date Submariner, which actually used to belong to you.
Yes.
I bought it off you.
Great watch.
I bought it off you to... I bought it off you so that you use the funds to buy the two-tone.
Yes.
Did I rip you off, Greg? Did I rip you off? Because there's been some nasty assholes out there who said I ripped them off when I sold them a Speedmaster.
Yeah.
And I didn't rip you off in any of the dealings I've had with you, have I?
Not at all.
Never?
No.
No, well, I must admit, the person who made the complaint has been sucking on the teat of society for a number of years, so it's not worthy of mention. But let's have a look here. Three beautiful Submariners. And the interesting thing is, with these three Submariners,
mm-hmm.
they are all similar vintage, because these three Submariners are mid-90s to middle noughties.
Yes.
So... From 1996 up until about 2004, a 8-year period. And the interesting thing is we've got some... I'll just go through the age of these pieces. This here, it's a 16618, which is a pre-ceramic, solid gold fucker. And it's a holes case.
Yep.
And this piece here is from about the late 90s, 96. 96, 97, 98.
Yes.
The next piece in the range is an A serial number, No Date Submariner.
Yep.
And this here is, it's an A serial number, 1999, year 2000, pre-ceramic, it's a holes case.
And it's a two-line too.
Yes, that's right. It's the non-certified chronometer version. And this is also... They changed the holes case last on the No Date. That was one of the last Submariners to get that update. And then, of course, we've got a 2004 Rolex Submariner 16613 two-tone.
Yes.
Bluesy.
Mm-hmm.
And they're just three similar vintage pre-ceramic Submariners. And
mine's got a no holes, I believe.
Yours is a no holes case. That's correct there. It's had that little update there, but we won't hold that against you, Greg. Quite okay. And Greg, with these with these pieces here, the question is, right, who is the bigger asshole out of all these three Submariners? Who's the biggest asshole out of the lot? And I think it would have to go to the solid gold.
I
think
have to say unanimously, yes.
Solid gold have to be the biggest asshole.
It would have to take the cake, definitely.
And I got to tell you, Greg, these three Submariners, we're talking about how much money? We're looking about, this is about 20,000 Australian for the solid gold. The No Date, what's that, 5.5?
Probably, but by now that would probably be the money.
Yeah, so that's 25.5. Plus, this here would be at least 8.5 now.
This would probably
because the dollars had
think,
the ass.
Yeah, I think already. So 28.5. I've seen them for sale dearer than I bought them.
So 34,000 fuckeroonies. 34 fuckers. 34,000 fuckeroonies.
Mm.
So, is that that could be a little mini collection in itself? What do you think? Three Submariners. What do you think? Eeny, meeny, miny, moe. Catcher. You know, what do you think?
Yes, it could be, because they're different. The one is two-tone, one is steel.
I mean, that could be a mini collection in itself, couldn't it? You could have three subs.
If somebody's a hardcore Submariner lover,
yes,
and you wanted a dressy, semi-dressy, and a sports one,
yes,
there's like a weekend. You could, in theory, use the gold one with your elegant suit.
Yes.
I don't think somebody wearing a solid gold sub would wear a tuxedo. They wouldn't have the class.
No, that's exactly it.
The two-tone would be used as your sort of, you know, I guess it would be used with your blazer, or it could be used with your tie and shirt, and the Submariner could be used for everything else. But having said that, because the Submariner steel is so simple, it could almost get away with being one for all three. But I'm just saying that if somebody wanted, if somebody's a hardcore Rolex Submariner collector,
yes,
that's the way to go, I guess.
What do you think, Greg? Tell me this, okay? Those three Submariners there, is that, would that be a cool collection to have three subs? Or that's too sub-focused?
I think it's too sub-focused. And this is somebody who really loves Submariners.
Yes.
But that doesn't mean I don't appreciate them.
Yes.
I think they're great watches, but I think one to two subs is the max, personally.
No, that's fair enough, Greg. I understand there. It's
I could say, for instance, well, maybe an O-Date sub and the Bluesy could be a nice combination if somebody's really sub-focused.
Yes.
You could use that with your, like in my line where I would wear a tie to work every day, I could use the Bluesy to every day to work, and the No-Date for weekends for everything else. So that,
yes.
Well, that could be a possibility, but that's just me. I mean, I still wouldn't probably focus it that way, but I still enjoy, I enjoy the Black Sub in steel very, very much.
Yes. Yes, no worries, Greg. Talking Submariners, these are three killer fuckers, and I gotta say, I think any one of those would be great. I love them. They're beautiful pieces, Greg. Thank you very much.
We specialize here in pre-owned Rolex watches. Rolex watch is a very special timepiece, and we always do the servicing exactly as factory specifications. We buy a pre-owned piece and we put it into brand new condition. We have Rolex certified technicians working on that. We completely disassemble the piece. We adjust and polish and change every single part of the watch.
You have to have certified watchmakers that know what they're doing. If you have an expensive car, you're just not going to bring it to any mechanic that doesn't know what they're doing.
You spend $5,000, it's like if you put money in the safe deposit box. And 1 or 2 years from now, you will keep having your $5,000. We have to spend a lot of money to get all this equipment together, but makes me feel I'm doing what I'm supposed to do. It's not a question of money, it's my passion.
Jewelers On Time, simply the best.